Hey everyone, have you ever been presented with some sort of design element like this when building for the web? How about something like this? Only one way to do this, right? Gotta make it an image and include it that way. Well, not so fast. We can build this right in our HTML with an inline SVG and a little CSS. And when we do so, they'll be accessible, dynamic, and responsive. In this video, I'll show you exactly how to do this. Let's get to it. To begin, you'll need to start with a vector graphic of your design. You'll also need to be able to edit it yourself in a vector graphics editor like Adobe Illustrator, or you'll need to have someone who can help you do so. This is because we'll need to add an invisible path for our text to be placed on. I was able to edit mine in Illustrator myself. I placed the path for this banner here, and for the purposes of this video, I added a black stroke to it just so that you can see where the path is placed, but in the end, it'll be invisible. Also, what I did here is I made it span the entire width of this region so that the text can expand all along this path to accommodate phrases of varying lengths. And for this banner, I did the same. Here's where I placed the text path. Okay, once you have your graphics and you've added your paths, you'll just need to export the banners as SVGs. It's a good idea to optimize these while you're at it. I like to use SVGO's missing GUI when doing this type of thing. Then I'll take a look at the file in an editor and remove whatever other junk I can. More of this can be removed. This just makes it a little lighter weight and easier to work with. Okay, so let's take the code from our first banner and paste it directly into our document. I'll go ahead and minimize everything but the path that we're going to use for our text. Now we can add the text with the text node. Since we're placing the text on a path, we'll use a textPath element. And let's connect it to our path using an href. Here we reference the ID of the path. To center this, we can set the path length on our path. Let's make it 2. This essentially means that our path now has a length of 2 units. Now on our text path, we'll have it start in the middle using a startOffset of 1. To fix the centering, we can add a text anchor style with a value of middle. All right, let's finish out the styling for the text while we're here. When we resize it, everything scales great. And we can even change the text. Of course, there is a limit to how long the text can be here, though. If it gets too long, it will break. All right, now let's add the next banner. Same thing, we'll add the text, text path, ID, path length, and start offset. And there it is. And like I said earlier, this is fully accessible and actually SEO friendly because the text is physically placed within the document, just like all other text. So it's a pretty nice way to pull this off. Okay, hopefully this was helpful for you. If you have any thoughts or questions, leave a comment below. And the link to the demo can be found in the description below as well. Thanks for watching.